forbidden we taste their blood. The angels just taught us a stern lesson in the foolishness of gathering together in one place and trying to engage in a fair fight.
Sevatar leaned on a support pillar, crossing his arms over his chest plate as he continued.
I'll be absolutely clear, since you are all so reluctant to take the hint. I will not let you take the Legion back into this war after such a crippling defeat. That's all there is to it. I will take the Atramentar, along with any other companies that choose to stand with me, and rejoin the War Master's fleet. There is nothing more we can do here. And I say that delaying the Dark Angels for almost 3 years is more than long enough. I'm finished with the Thramas Crusade. I am taking my companies to Terra. I plan to see the real war before the final day dawns. The rest of the Legion should come with me. I may lose my temper if you try to keep fighting this meaningless war.
Malithos looked at his brother in raw disbelief for a moment.
Are you mad, Sevatar?
I don't think so. I feel fine.
How would you stop us from staying? Asked Var Jahan.
I kill you, of course. But let's hope it doesn't come to that. Emotions are running high, and my spear is all the way over there.
He gestured to where it lay on the table.
Brother, if you're finished acting the fool, may we focus on the matters at hand?
Focus on them all you like. I'm going to see the Primarch with my own eyes, rather than rely on your prattling about his demise.
Sevatar moved away from the pillar, heading for the sealed bulkhead.
Your spear, Sevatar!
I will be back for it soon enough. Enjoy your discussion, brothers.
He walked from the chamber, his silhouette filling the entryway for a moment before he turned the corner. The door rumbled closed. Malithos shook his head.
I grow weary of him, he said to the others.
Many of us do, Cel Herec replied.
When we rebuild the Kyroptera, we would be better served if Sevatar found himself unable to rejoin.
Malithos sneered, as only he could do.
Why the spineless turn of phrase?
Just say the truth. I'll kill him myself when the time comes.
Var Jahan scarcely listened to their words. His attention lingered on Sevatar's spear, resting on the table. The blade was a monstrous glaive. The haft a solid length of black iron and ridged ceramite, the rear butted by a brutal spike with a crystalline power generator above. Every warrior within the 18 legions knew of that blade. What far fewer knew was the nature of the haft's secondary generator. Having fought at Sevatar's side many times, Var Jahan knew its purpose very well indeed. Ultimately, Var Jahan trusted none of his brothers, least of all those in the Kyroptera. When his teeth began to itch with the onset of displacing air pressure, he was the only one of the three captains not surprised. He was also the only one running for the door.
The assassins appeared in a storm of white noise and etheric mist, as the captains recoiled, raising futile hands to ward off the blinding light. All three knew just what that thunder heralded. Malithos and Cel Herec reached for their weapons, which was why they died. Var Jahan never stopped running.
The Atramentar manifested across the chamber, wreathed in the greasy aftersmoke of teleportation flare, their bolters already raised.
We have come for you,
the first of the Terminators growled, before their guns opened up in a unified cascade. Var Jahan heard his brothers die, heard their cries and gurgles across the vox, over the pounding of his boots and both hearts. Bolts took him high in the back and low in the left leg, sending him into a stumble, falling down onto a deck being riven by detonating shells. He rolled across the decking, never ceasing, and threw himself through the automated bulkhead. In the corridor beyond, 27th Captain Var Jahan lay panting on the decking. He looked up at Sevatar. The first captain stood with his back to the wall, arms crossed over his breastplate, looking down in idle curiosity.
Hello, Captain, said Sevatar.
Varjahan was rising when the doors opened again, releasing gunsmoke into the corridor. A squad of Atramentar Terminators stood in their hulking warplate, immense bolters aimed at the prey that had fled them.
"Stand down,"
Sevatar said, and offered a hand to help his brother up.
"This one was intelligent enough to sense my intent. He gets to live."
Varjahan almost spat. "Most generous of you."
Sevatar chuckled before replying,
"I thought so too."
"Why did you kill them?"
Varjahan moved so his back wasn't facing the Atramentar.
"Why did you want us dead? Fratricide, brother? Has it really come to this?"
"We came to this the moment you three fools decided it was best to kill the Legion simply to expunge some imaginary stain on our imaginary honour."
"But the preparation..."
"I had a feeling the Kyroptera would need reorganising. I was right."
"You killed them because they disagreed with you. Sevatar, you are insane."
The first captain gave a subtle shrug.
"So I am often told. What matters is that the Legion needs the Kyroptera now more than ever, and we will not lead our brethren back onto the Dark Angel's blades."
"But the War Master..."
Sevatar's hand was at his throat before the sentence could end. The first captain lifted him, slamming him back against the wall.
"Do I look like I care what the War Master wants of me?"
Sevatar's skullish faceplate stared with its red eyelenses.
"We never cared what the Emperor wanted of us. Why should we waste our lives out here in the back end of the galaxy dancing to the War Master's tune?"
He released Varjahan, walking back into the chamber.
"He has leashed us for 3 years. I am done with obedience. To the abyss with Horus and his arrogant whims. He's no better than the Emperor."
Varjahan followed his brother. He had to step over Cel Herec's smoking corpse, sparing it barely a glance. Malithos had died in similar indignity. The ninth captain's body was half-draped across the central table, blood pooling across the surface in a spreading lake.
"True independence, then. Our allies in the other legions are simply alliances of convenience."
"Better that than living shackled to a sickened, dying Imperium."
Sevatar's voice was softer now, more distant.
"Varjahan, forgive my display of anger."
He recovered his spear and rested it on his shoulder guard.
"I'm going to see our father."
As the footsteps faded, Varjahan looked to the towering forms of the Night Lord's Terminators. They offered no hint of their emotions or thoughts, staring impassively through the scarlet eye lenses of their brutish war helms.
"I know you all," Varjahan said to them. "By name and reputation, even if I've not served with all of you. Thorian, Malek, Jakresh."
He listed their names one by one, nodding to them each in turn.
"What did Sevatar offer you to make such loyal warriors? What is it he holds over you that makes you serve him, even through the spilled blood of our Legion kin?"
Thorian, commander of the Atramentar, shook his head as coils of teleportation mist started forming around their dark armor.
"He gives us the truth."
Their departure was as sudden and loud as their arrival, leaving Varjahan alone with the bodies of his